My name is Jonathan Haltewanger. It is my pleasure to talk to you about a man who many thought to be infamous when it comes to medicine. Who is Dr. Hans Alfred Niebuhr? What did he do that is so important for your health today? Dr. Niebuhr was a physician from Hanover, Germany, who viewed the universe with the perspective of a physicist. When he approached health, it was with this background in physics that he was able to make numerous discoveries. And to show how it applied, he wrote the book Revolution in Medicine. He collaborated with Dr. Franz Kohler on many of his formulas, and from this developed an orthomolecular approach to health. Orthomolecular is the theory that health may be maximized by creating an optimal environment for our body's cells through introducing nutrition with natural substances. By the end of his life, Dr. Niebuhr had an extensive background of places he studied, worked, and medical societies he belonged to. He led study after study throughout decades of research and wrote hundreds of papers, many of which are stored at the Keith Brewer Science Library, a library that stores original works of other great minds, such as Nikola Tesla and Dr. Keith Brewer. Links to the library site can be found in our references and contact section of this site. When Dr. Niebuhr began his advanced education, it was post-World War II Germany. He studied at the Johann Gutenberg University and the University of Freiburg. His medical education came from the University of Hamburg, and he worked for years in the United States with the Sloan Kettering Cancer Institute. He was the president of the German Society of Oncology and the World Cancer Congress. He had a long-running practice as an internist at the Paracelsus Silversee Hospital in Germany, which is a major holistic hospital of the region. He kept up with his practice at the hospital, all while running a substantially sized private practice as well. He did all this because he really cared about his patients, and he believed in the capabilities of a holistic medicine. His passion was finding natural ways for the body to heal itself. There was controversy when it came to Dr. Niebuhr. It revolved around his cancer and multiple sclerosis treating techniques. The obstacles he faced bringing his discoveries to the United States were substantial. While his cancer techniques generated controversy, what did not have as much controversy surrounding them were his mineral transporters. And now, we've had decades to discover what they can do. They are effective in delivering minerals into different parts of our cells to correct and improve imbalances and severe deficiencies any person may have. I want to share with you a little of the incredible character this man had. I never met Dr. Niebuhr myself, but my father, Dr. Steve Haltewanger, has studied under him directly. He told me that one day he was sitting in Dr. Niebuhr's office, and over the course of 30 minutes, Niebuhr took constant phone calls of patients. During that time, my father heard him speak 5 languages. He said, "You know, I only noticed him speak 5 languages in that brief time, but probably he knew a bunch more fluently. He was just that kind of person." Niebuhr's mineral transporters are of high importance because the current market of minerals to the average consumer is saturated with easily produced, cheaper costing forms that lose their effectiveness traveling through the digestive tract, with not enough crossing cell membranes sufficiently. The average person generally has no idea how to properly support their health. What I want to leave you with is the knowledge that Dr. Niebuhr was a great man, and that he pioneered mineral transporters for the benefit of all to use. Why would anyone want to consume anything less than the best? He patented and contracted with just one manufacturer to make sure that his products stayed to his exact specifications, retaining their electrical properties for total effectiveness. This is so that they wouldn't be modified to a form with less effectiveness, because his formulas worked, and he didn't want them changed to inferior forms, as they were his lasting legacy for the world. Please, check out some of the other videos on this site to learn more about what these mineral transporters do and how they support the different systems of your body.